Imagine a future cat-topia where both cats and people are applying to the physics and astronomy departments. In astronomy, two cats are accepted and two rejected, while one human is accepted and one is rejected. On the other hand, in physics, one cat gets in and two don't, while two humans get in and four don't. So overall at the university, three cats are accepted and four rejected for a 43% acceptance rate, while three humans are accepted and five rejected for a 38% acceptance rate. Is the university discriminating against humans in its application process? Possibly not. That's because if each department reviews its own applications, then the numbers show that the astronomy department lets in 50% of cats and 50% of humans, which seems fair, and the physics department lets in 33% of cats and 33% of humans, which again seems fair. The reason then for the apparent unfairness at the university level is the imbalance in how many cats and humans apply to each department. More of the cats applied to the astronomy department, which happened to let in a greater proportion of applicants, regardless of species, while more of the humans applied to physics, which let in a smaller proportion of applicants. This situation is another illustration of Simpson's statistical paradox, and something like it actually happened at Berkeley in the 1970s, which realized it was letting in 44% of men applying to the graduate school, but only 35% of women. Careful analysis was able to show that women tended to apply more to departments that had less funding and fewer places, like English, and men tended to apply more to less competitive departments, like engineering. Thus, within each department, which was the level at which applications were evaluated, there wasn't obvious evidence of gender discrimination among applicants. If anything, women were favored. And yet, the unequal distribution of women and men across departments resulted in an unequal distribution of women and men at the university overall. The question then is, what caused the unequal distribution of women and men to begin with? One can of course imagine a sinister institution that knows how Simpson's paradox works and wants to discriminate against a particular group. All they have to do is advertise smaller, more competitive departments more heavily to that group, and vice versa for groups they want to promote. More realistically, certain departments or fields may have reputations for being unwelcoming and unsupportive towards women, even if they let them in fairly. And it's also possible that other aspects of a university itself attract applicants who are more likely to follow gendered career stereotypes. But ultimately, as the Berkeley study concluded, the problem is a bigger, societal one. The absence of a demonstrable bias in the admissions system does not give grounds for concluding that there must be no bias anywhere else in the educational process. Women are shunted towards fields of study that are generally more crowded, less productive of completed degrees, less well-funded, and that frequently offer poorer professional employment prospects. Those words were written in a statistics paper in 1975, and more recent statistics tell us that they still remain true today, which is unfortunate if you think women and men should have equal opportunities and/or be paid equally for equal work. So the paradox isn't really in the statistics, since after careful analysis, the statistics tell us we're biased, and even hint at where those biases are or aren't coming into play. No, the paradox is that we've remained so reluctant to fight our biases, even when they're put in plain sight. This video is sponsored by Skillshare, the online learning site with courses on all sorts of creative, business, and technological skills, like proper knife skills, or how to make animated graphs for a video, or how to fly a drone, or how to design a logo for your knife-carrying drone-flying animated graph company, and so on. You can get 2 months of Skillshare for free by going to skillsh/minutephysics. Again, that's skillsh/minutephysics.